So hello guys, we are done with our discussion regarding stocks. Now we're going to demo how to make the stock. First stock that we're going to do is a brown stock. So our base is a beef bones. So first we're going to bake or caramelize the beef so that we can achieve a brown, deep brown colored stock. So first we have beef bones. This is a 3 kilograms of beef bone. So half of our recipe that is written on your module is our demo for today. So first, the beef bones. This is optional. We're going to put cooking oil. So pwede namang hindi tayo gumamit ng cooking oil for caramelization of the beef bone. So first, we're going to put 1/4 cup of cooking oil. So any oil will do. Wag lang siguro mga flavored oil like sesame oil and olive oil. So just a simple vegetable or coconut. After putting oil, we're going to put this inside the oven for about 45 minutes to 1 hour. I'm going to show you after 45 minutes what is a baked bone, what is the color of the baked bones. So our beef bones is already for 40 minutes in the oven. So halfway na siya, halfway done. Then, dalagay natin yung mirepoix, which is carrots, celery, and the onion. So ibe-bake pa uli natin to for about 20 minutes to 30 minutes para ma-brown din yung mga vegetables sa oven. So ano pang ibang way natin para ma-brown natin yung mga vegetables na or the mirepoix? Pwede natin itong igisa ng matagal sa konting oil hanggang maging brown siya. So kasi bakit natin kailangan i-brown din ang vegetables natin? Kasi we're making a brown stock, our base for our brown sauce, which is called Espanol, para makuha natin yung color na gusto nating ma-achieve, kailangan natin i-brown yung bones and the vegetables or the mirepoix. So, we're going to bake this again for another 20 minutes to about 30 minutes and I'm going to show you guys what will happen with the bones and the vegetables. Oh, see you guys after 20 to 30 minutes. So, we're done baking our bones and the vegetables. So, first thing we need to do is to deglaze. So deglazing, maglalagay lang tayo ng any liquid, pwedeng water, pwedeng wine. This helps the caramelized part of the beef that stick into our pan to soften para makuha natin yung brown niya talaga. So as you can see, may mga brown na lumalabas dito. So that helps, water helps soften the caramelized portions of the meat that stick into the pan na matunaw. So afterwards, we're going to transfer it inside a pan or a pot. So we already transfer the baked vegetables or the mirepoix and the bones inside a pot. So we're going to make a bouquet garni. Meron siyang thyme, bay leaf, parsley, or we can use parsley stems, peppercorn, and garlic. So we're going to tie this using a twine or kung anong mga pantali na meron kayo na hindi basta-basta masusunog sa mainit. So, bakit natin nilalagay sa pouch ang ating herbs and spices para hindi siya kumalat sa ating stock at madali itong alisin. So, we're going to put the bouquet garni, our tomato paste, then water. We should use cold water when doing stocks. So we're going to boil this down, and after boiling, we're going to simmer it for 4 hours. So hope you see you guys after 4 hours. Okay, we're done with our first stock, which is brown stock, and we use beef bones. And now this is our second stock, which is a white stock. Our base for this stock is chicken bones. So ano pinagkaiba ng beef stock na brown and a white stock? So ang difference niya is, ang brown stock usually binebake siya to achieve a deep brown color, and also we add tomato paste to add a dark color on our stock. Then si white stock, very plain lang, the vegetables or the mirepoix, the bouquet garni, and the bones with water. So ano ang kailangan natin for our white stock, which is gagawa tayo ng chicken stock. So first is we need chicken bones and our mirepoix. Mirepoix contains carrots, celery, and onion. Then our bouquet garni contains peppercorn, thyme, parsley, bay leaf, and garlic. So today we're going to use dried parsley. So si dried parsley, and meron tayong fresh parsley. So ano ang difference nun sa paano natin siya gagamitin? Ang paggamit sa kanya, ang difference niya is kung ano ang timbang ng fresh parsley natin, dapat kalahati nun ang timbang ng dried parsley. Why? Because dried herbs and spices cuts around 50% of the water content of the herbs and spices. So, yung kalahati ng gulay, for example, or ng herbs and spices is, we need a kilo of parsley. Ang kalahati nun is 500 grams, kasi bakit? Pag na-dried siya, nawawala yung water content niya, which is almost 50% or the 500 grams of a kilo. So, ano ba ang kailangan natin? Di ba nabanggit na natin, we need a bone, mirepoix, we need a water, and the bouquet garni. So, I'm going to show you how to make the bouquet garni. First, we need a cheesecloth, or we can use katsa, yung mga pinagamitan ng harina, yung bagnong harina, or yung sa iba, ang bouquet garni is talagang bouquet ng parang flower siya na nakatali. So, since we're going to use cheesecloth, so ganito siya ginagawa. So, first, we're going to put all our herbs and spices inside the cheesecloth. So, peppercorn, the dried parsley, then thyme, then bay leaves, and garlic. So, yan. So, ang gagawin natin ngayon, itatali natin siya, isa-secure natin na walang lalabas na herbs and spices doon sa ating stock. Bakit natin kailangan gawin to? Para madaling alisin itong bag na to sa stock pot natin. Kasi pangit siya na nakahalo doon sa mga bones and sa stock, kasi mahihirapan tayong strain. Ready na ang lahat ng ingredients natin for our white stock. So, first, we need a stock pot or sauce pot na better kung mas malaki, kasi mas mabilis mag-boil and hindi magka-crowd yung pot natin. So first, natin yung bones. So yung ano natin na to, itong recipe natin na to is the half of our recipe that is written in your module. So we have beef bones. So we're going to put the beef bones inside the pot. Then, our mirepoix, which is the celery, the carrots, and the onion. So afterwards, we're going to put our bouquet garni. Then, a cold water. So we should always start with cold water. We're going to let it boil first. High fire muna tayo. So, pag na-boil na siya, we're going to simmer it for about 4 hours. So, 2 hours is enough. Pero kung we have enough time, 4 hours or more, mas okay sa stock natin para mas concentrated siya. So we're going to boil this first, then simmer it for 4 hours. So okay, our stock is already boiling. We're going to put it into simmer. So hihinaan lang natin ng konti yung apoy niya para mabagal yung cooking process niya, which is cold simmering, para the longer the cooking process, the flavor is more deep and more intense. So hihinaan lang natin siya, and we're going to let it simmer. Then we're going to scald yung mga itim-itim. So parang yung pag nagninilaga yung nanay nyo or yung mga tita nyo, may inaalis silang mga impurities sa ibabaw na mga ano, ang tawag ng mga matatanda yun, yung mga dugo na namuo. Antay lang natin, siguro every 30 minutes balikan natin, alisin natin impurities sa ibabaw. So ayan, nagsisimmer na siya. So nakikita nyo, very small na yung mga bubbles niya. So hayaan lang natin siya ng ganyan for about 4 hours. Pero pwede, for the chicken stock, pwede na to for around 2 to 3 hours. This is our third and fourth stock. So now we're going to make a vegetable stock. And tuturo ko sa inyo kung paano yung fish stock. Sobrang simple lang. It's like the vegetable stock. Ang difference lang, sa fish stock, we're going to use dry white wine. Para saan yung white wine? Para maalis yung lansa ng fish. So, paano ba gumawa ng first ng vegetable stock? We only need mirepoix. So, carrots, onion, and celery. But we can use daikon or labanos. Pwede tayong magdagdag kung anong gulay yung mga gusto natin. Huwag lang yung mga colored na gulay and very pungent na gulay para hindi masira yung stock natin. Kasi dapat yung stock natin flavorful but simple. Kasi this will be the base for our sauces and soup. So, lalagyan natin sa pot yung mirepoix natin. Then afterwards, bouquet garni. So, alam na natin ang content ng bouquet garni. Lalagyan natin siya. Then, water. So, lagyan natin yung water. So, bubuksan lang natin yung apoy. Then, pag nagbo-boil na siya, isi-simmer natin for 30 minutes. So, sobrang simple ng vegetable stock. So, vegetable stock, we only need mirepoix, bouquet garni, and water. While fish stock, we need the mirepoix, bouquet garni, water, wine, and fish bones. So, dapat ang ginagamit natin mga fish bones, yung mga lean fishes. Kasi pag gumamit tayo ng mga oily fishes like salmon, tuna, yung stock natin magiging oily. So, dapat yung mga pompano lang, maya-maya, or even bangus, pwede natin gamitin as a stock. So, we're going to wait for our vegetable stock to boil and simmer for 30 minutes and we're done. So, after 4 hours, we're done simmering our stock. So, kanina gumamit tayo ng 2 liters of water. So, after 4 hours, it will reduce almost in half. So, yung 2 liters of water, nagiging 1 liter na lang siya ng stock. So, I'm going to show you the 3 different stocks that we've done earlier. So, first we have the brown stock, which is boiled for 4 hours. The bones are baked and the vegetables. So, the base of this is beef. The second one is we have a white stock or chicken stock. And the third one is vegetable stock. So, we use the mirepoix and bouquet garni plus water to make a vegetable stock. So, these 3 stocks, we're going to use these in our sauce and soup for later. So, after this stock, we're going to discuss about the thickening agents that we can use. Ano yung thickening agents? Is ginagamit pang palapot. So, I'm going to show you how to make different thickening agents. So, see you guys in our next video.